Hi everyone, this is Dr. K. Kannadasan, Assistant Professor at Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University. I am going to talk about the analysis of covariance, how this analysis of covariance will be done using SPSS package. And for that we need to open up the SPSS that you have installed in your system. Just double click on it and the page will appear just like this. And just for the demonstration purpose, I have already put up the datas, and here you can see one is group, one column is showing about the group and the other column is showing about the pre-test scores, and the other column is showing about the post-test scores. And usually we used to enter in the variable view, so the groups that you have in your study and to add these groups, you usually in the value that for which group that you are assigning this value that need to be mentioned. For example, I can show you another example. Like for example, if you want to have another group and you can value that group as 4, and you can say that is experimental group 4. And if you give on add, that is added. And when you want to remove it, any of the group, that you can click on it and just remove it. And then click OK. Now your group part is ready. And then similarly, like the variables that you want to test, just enter the variables pre-test scores and the variables post-test scores. And of course, you need to give the measure, as whether it is ordinal measure or scale measure or nominal measure, and I have put it everything on a scale, and now you can view the data. And the total number of samples in the study is 45, and equally being taken, each group is equally taken, the number of samples. And group 1, 15 samples, and group 2, another 15 samples. And in SPSS, for calculating analysis of covariance, you need to enter in your data in a vertical manner rather than doing horizontal manner. This will help you to calculate. So now our data are ready, and let's see how to perform. And for that, you need to click on the analysis button that you can view at the top of the screen. So just click on it, and then in the drop down box you have to select general linear model, and in that you have three options: univariate, multivariate, repeated measures. Here you select univariate, and a dialog box will open. In the dialog box on your left side of the screen, you can see three components which is available in the data view is given. Now put the group factor, just click on the group factor and add it up in the fixed factor, and just click on the post data which you have collected after the treatment should be put up in the dependent variable. And the data that is collected before the treatment starts should be included in the covariate section. Now the left hand side box has become empty, and you have certain options on your right side. You can see model, contrast plots, save options, bootstrap. I'm not going to use much of this, just click on the options and and you want to find out the means of the means between the groups, just transfer from this factor from the left hand side box to the right hand side box where the display means are there, and also click on the group input. And now when you want to see any differences among the paired group signal, significant difference, you can view through compare main effects. Just click on it, and the post-op test will be, the comparison will be done on a least significant difference method. And certain options have been given, like descriptive statistics, estimates of effect size, is homogeneity test, residual plot, lack of fit, and many other things are here. And in a simple manner, you just click on the descriptive statistics to know the mean and standard deviation of the calculation that we are going to perform, and the significance level is also fixed at 0.05 level. You just click on the continue, and here you just go ahead with OK. Now another box will open like this. This is the result that you have received, and here different sections are there. One shows about between subject factors, that is groups. In each group, how many samples that you have taken, it is clear. And in descriptive statistics, you have the means of the scores of pre-test as well as post-test. This is the post-test mean that you have received and the standard deviation of it. And this is the main box, you can see. And this is the box where you got the results of analysis of covariance. So analysis of covariance, the calculated or the obtained value that you received is 477.420. And the significant, if you see, it is highly significant. And this particular, the significant value should be less than 0.05. So it is less than 0.01 even. So this is highly significant at 0.05 level. And the pair-wise comparisons also have come. When you really want to know the results of ANOVA, you need to consider this table, and this is what we have seen there. So this the data which you have collected for three different groups before a treatment and after treatment is found to be significant. Thank you for watching this video.